Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from around the world. Our headlines: Andrés Arauz wins first round as Ecuador heads towards a presidential runoff election. Iran once again reaffirms commitment to nuclear deal. Mass protests against military coup continue across Myanmar. And Chicago city government announces tentative deal over school reopening. In our first story, progressive candidate Andrés Arauz has won the first round of Ecuador's presidential elections. Arauz has secured 31.74% of the votes as per the quick count conducted by the National Electoral Council. Given that no candidate has crossed the 50% threshold or received 40% of the votes with a 10% lead, a runoff election will be held on April 11th. However, it is as yet unclear who will challenge Arauz in the second round. As per the latest reports, the margin between the second and third candidates is extremely narrow, making the results too close to call. As the vote count continues, here is a video feature on the election results. Now, next story, Iran Supreme Leader Ayatollah Khamenei on Sunday, February 7th, affirmed the country's commitment to the JCPOA, also known as the Iran nuclear deal. He said that Iran would, to quote him, return to the JCPOA obligations once the US lifts its sanctions in action and not in words or on paper, and once the sanction relief is verified by Iran. Khamenei was addressing officers of the Iranian Air Force on the occasion of the anniversary of the defection from the monarchy and joining the Islamic Revolution in 1979. Khamenei emphasized that Americans and Europeans have no right to set any conditions of their own on Iran, as they have violated the rules of the JCPOA themselves. He was replying to the US Secretary of State Antony Blinken's demand that in order for US to join the deal again, Iran has to first return to all its obligations under the JCPOA. The JCPOA is signed by Iran and the US along with five other countries in 2015. However, Donald Trump, claiming that the deal was too one-sided in favor of Iran, withdrew from it in 2018 and imposed multiple sanctions on Iran under its so-called maximum pressure campaign. The aim of this campaign was to force Iran to renegotiate the deal, including its missile program and regional policies. Tehran, after giving due warning to the European signatories to abide by the deal and take effective measures to protect Iran from American sanctions, started reverting some of its commitments to the deal last year. It is maintained that all these steps are under the provisions of the JCPOA, and once the US rejoins the deal and lifts sanctions, it will come back to full compliance within days. Anti-coup resistance continues to intensify in Myanmar as mass protests entered their third consecutive day on February 8th. Thousands of people, including members of labor unions, government officials, and healthcare workers, gathered on the streets of Yangon today. Massive protests were also held in the capital city, with tens of thousands of people in attendance. Police forces launched water cannons to disperse the crowds at some sites, and the military has warned that action will be taken against those who break the law. Martial law was also declared in parts of the capital of Mandalay. The order has banned large gatherings and protests, and a curfew has been imposed from 8 p.m. to 4 a.m. Activists are calling for a general strike as part of the nationwide civil disobedience campaign. Doctors and healthcare workers had also issued a call to strike last week and stopped work across 30 towns. Teachers, garment workers, and government employees have also joined the protests. The military had suspended internet services and restricted phone lines on February 6th. However, telephone and internet services were partially restored the next day. Restrictions had also been placed on social media platforms, including a block on Facebook till February 7th. Local activist groups have estimated that over 160 people have been detained so far. Protesters are demanding a restoration of the elected government as the military continues to contest the 2020 election results. Deposed State Councillor Aung San Suu Kyi and the President have been placed under house arrest in the capital city. Both are also facing criminal charges and have been remanded in custody till February 15th. Several lawmakers from Suu Kyi's party have also defied military orders to vacate their living quarters in the capital city. These members proceeded to swear oaths of office and held a parliamentary session within their living quarters on February 4th. Myanmar has been placed under a state of emergency for 1 year, and all power has been handed over to the commander-in-chief. And finally, we go to the United States, where the Chicago city government has announced a tentative deal for reopening schools. The announcement was made on February 7th, a day before the schools were scheduled for a limited reopening. The tentative agreement follows months of organizing by Chicago's teachers for a safe return to school amid the COVID-19 pandemic. The Chicago school district is the third largest in the U.S., with over 355,000 students enrolled in 642 schools. The deal requires ratification before February 11th, when a phased return to in-person training has been scheduled. According to the deal, in-person schooling for preschool and special education students will start from February 11th. Students in kindergarten to 5th grade will return to schools on March 1st, followed by those in 6th to 8th grade from March 8th. The government has also assured vaccination for 1,500 school staff members per week. Teachers who themselves have health conditions or live with family members who do will be allowed to teach remotely. Parents will also be given the option to choose between in-person or online learning. While the deal provides temporary relief, the Chicago Teachers Union has warned that a permanent deal with the Chicago Public Schools Board and the city government is yet to be reached. The union has stated that negotiations over federal safety guidelines and other important issues regarding the reopening of the schools will continue. That's all we have time for today. We'll be back tomorrow with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch.